Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. Today, I'm in the beautiful Santa Monica Pier, and it's right that way. With me here, we have the Insta360 Pro 1 camera and Pro 2 camera. Also, we have a Canon Obsidian on my hand. Today, I gotta do some camera comparison between all three of camera, and I gotta finally do my first official review of the Insta360 Pro 2. To tell you what I like about this camera and what I don't like about this camera. If you cannot wait to the end to watch this full review and just want to find out what I think is the best for you, so I can tell you that if you are a documentary filmmaker or independent filmmaker, that you're always on the run, this is definitely a great affordable camera to invest. If you're like me, my high frame rate production, meaning filming dance content, sport content, that's also a great option. If you don't know why I said that, keep watching. To keep it short and sweet, I break it down 10 points you need to know before you decide to purchase the Pro 2 if you are using the camera for video work. What I'm going to tell you will be very different from what you heard from their marketing or other paid media or reviews. I have 3 months hands-on experience with the camera, both in commercial jobs, documentary filmmaking, and my personal passion projects, dance music videos. Number one, the image quality. You are now watching a side-by-side comparison between the Pro 1 and the Pro 2 cameras doing sunset in Santa Monica, both in manual mode, exact same setting with ISO 100. The Pro 2 captured 120 megabit per second per lens, and the Pro 1 is around 40 megabit per second. And as you see here, the image quality is a dramatic increase from Pro 1. Let's punch in 50% and look at my face and the sunset. I really enjoy the new color science of the Pro 2, as you see my skin color is less reddish compared to the Pro 1. Look at the tree in front of the sun, which is the highlight area. You can see more of the tree in the Pro 2. If you look at the tree behind me, which is the shadow area, you can see more detail instead of just black compared to the Pro 1. How about sharpness? If you punch in 100% and look at the Santa Monica Ferris wheel and the roller coaster in the far distance, you can clearly see more in the Pro 2. For the Pro 1, it is just a blurry mess. You can also see digital noise in the shadow in Pro 1, which Pro 2 in regular mode has a nice and crunchy black. In conclusion, to put it in an easy to understand 2D video term, if the Pro 1 is 720p in 360, then the Pro 2 is 1080p in 360. The quality differences is very significant. What about the comparison between Canon Obsidians? Here is the side-by-side comparison. All three cameras are in ISO 100, shutter speed 1 over 60 in 30 frames per second. The perfect setting which you don't really get in VR. By the way, just a shooting tip, golden hours is the best time of the day to shoot VR, which you get perfect exposure and 1 over 60 shutter speed. The Obsidian footage is straight out of the Kandao studio. As you can see, the color looks a lot nicer, more saturated in the Insta360 Pro 2. The Obsidian look very purplish and less saturated. They are both in auto white balance. Also, the Pro 2 has a nice contrast as well. And this is why I said the Insta360 Pro 2 is great for run and gun documentary filmmakers and news reporters, like my friend from NBC who used Pro 2. The idea behind Insta360 Pro 2 regular mode is to make it simple and easy to use with minimal post-production. The footage you saw here can be directly uploaded as final products. With high volume production like documentary and news, this is very important. Time is money, If I don't need to hire a colorist to color grade, I save money and time. Let's punch in 50% and check the highlight and shadows. You notice the red sunset color in the highlight is lost in the Obsidian footage. It seems like the dynamic range of the Insta360 Pro 2 is better than Obsidian's, but I still notice more detail in the shadow in the Obsidian's. It is really hard to compare the dynamic range in regular mode. Luckily, both cameras has a logarithmic mode, aka log mode. Number 2. Insta360 Pro 2 comes with an impressive eye lock. We all know the Pro 1 flat mode is useless, not a true logarithmic mode. But the new eye lock is very impressive. Here is the side-by-side comparison between the Kendall Obsidian lock mode and the Insta360 Pro 2 eye lock, both in ISO 100, 1/60 shutter speed. Again, the eye lock already come with a very nice base color, especially the sky, nice and rich blue. The Pro 2 also has better highlight fall off as pointed out here. Let's punch in 50%. In both cameras, we can see the bright red sun. Usually wouldn't be able to if you are using a consumer camera like GoPro Fusion. I attempt to do some color grading, but I still cannot get that rich blue the Insta360 Pro 2 has. Let's jump to distant objects like the Ferris wheel. The Pro 2 looks a little bit sharper than the Obsidian. But again, this is not a fair comparison, as I only had Obsidian S, which only do 6K in 3D. I will need the Obsidian R, which do 8K in 3D to have a fair resolution and sharpness comparison. When I throw a LUT in both camera, I can see the shadow in the Obsidian is still a little bit better, sharper and less noise. This can be caused by the stitching software. In general, the Kendall Studio Stitcher is better than the Insta360 Stitcher in depth mode. You will see in the actual 3D360 video in VR headset, which I will provide the link in this video. But Insta360 does come with 3 months free Mystica VR subscription, which can easily solve the stitching issue follow this tutorial. A lot of users complain about the stitching quality of this camera, but let's face it, Insta360 is not a software company, they're a camera maker. It's unfair to rely on perfect stitch on a camera manufacturer, but you can actually get perfect stitch by doing the work. And I mean learn how to do it with Color AVP or Mystica VR. Also, I want to point out for all of those complaints about stitching, Kendall Obsidian S captures 3000 times 3000 pixels for a single lens. Insta360 Pro 2, if you shoot in mono, it is actually 3840 times 1920. Stitching is going to be tough. My suggestion is, even you only need mono, shoot a stereo 8K, which give you 3840 times 2880 per lens, which is a lot more horizontal coverage. Still not as good as Kendall Obsidian S, but at least close enough to eliminate some of the stitching issues. Number 3. High frame rate production. I already made a video explaining the advantage of high frame rate of the Pro 2. I highly recommend you go check it out in VR headset, and I'm not gonna repeat myself here. Number 4. Low light production. Believe it or not, if you shoot in iLock and can control your ISO below 800, you can actually shoot low light. Yes, the result is nowhere compared to a DSLR like Sony or Panasonic GH5S, but Insta360 Pro 2 shoots stereo 3D360. Your low light rigs does not, or very expensive to do. Just look at the footage here. With simple 360 post-production, including denoise and VR sharpen, the Pro 2 low light footage looks very impressive. But I have to be honest, if a majority of your production is indoor low light, then building a low light rig is a better option. Here is an example. Number 5. HDR video. Insta360 Pro 2 is the first ever 360 cameras can do HDR video. In both monoscopic and stereoscopic 360. I am not an HDR video expert, and you cannot really see HDR, the true HDR video, without an HDR display with 1000 nits and above with 10-bit color depth. I did some HDR video during sunset. Let's take a look and compare. Even without an HDR display, you can tell the highlight is even better with even richer color. The beautiful California sunset with the burning red is truly captured in its original form. In HDR display, this might look even better, I hope. But it does come with a price. As you see, the shadow in the palm tree is highly compressed and losing details. Noise is introduced. Let's switch to Kandao Obsidian for comparison, which captured at the exact same moment. At a glance, the Kandao Obsidian log mode with color grading actually looks better. You need to know, with HDR, you are losing the ability to manually adjust ISO and shutter speed, meaning that you are losing all those power to color grade in post. Let's punch in and take a closer look. The sunset, aka the highlight, no doubt about it, the HDR looks a lot nicer than the blowout Kandao Obsidians. So much highlight detail are captured in the HDR mode, like the clouds, are lost in Obsidians. Let's punch in a little bit more, like 150%, and we will look at the light in the Ferris wheel and the restaurant, I believe is the Red Lobster, underneath it. You can't even notice those lights in Obsidian, but in Pro 2 HDR, they look amazing. Well, at a price. Look at the close-up palm tree on the side of the PCH, which is moving by the ocean breeze. They look all blurry with high amount of digital noise. Same as the shadow. In my opinion, HDR video is not ready yet. Even though I want it to work so bad, and it is a great leap forward by Insta360. In conclusion, HDR video should not be the reason you purchased the Pro 2, as there are still too much question marks around the HDR features. In general, to capture HDR video, need at least a 10-bit color depth camera, for example, the Panasonic GH5, or better, RED cinematic camera. Insta360 Pro 2 can only capture 8-bit, unless there are some untold secrets in China that can generate true HDR video with such a low spec. I would not base on this feature as my purchasing decision. Thank you for watching this review of the brand new Insta360 Pro 2. As I mentioned, I have 10 points and I only cover 5 here. In the next part, I will focus more on usability innovation, like the far side and the flow state stabilization. We will find out if these features deliver their promise or not. We will also go over live streaming, which is an essential part of video production for clients. I will also go over points that I don't like about this camera and things that drive me absolutely crazy on set. So, subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell to catch the next episode when it releases. Give me a like so I can continue to share what I know and get you to the next level in 360 production. Until next time, stay creative, my friends.